Bobby. Welcome everyone. We'll start off with Bahir Ismat, followed, we'll introduce, give a brief on ICANN, followed by Dr. Steve Crocker, and then Mr. Yoran Marby will give a brief on the key topics at ICANN 60 and what's being discussed. Abdurrahman Marzouqi will then give an idea of why the TRA hosted this event, and we'll leave the floor open for questions. Please.
Thank you, Luna. Good morning, everyone. My name is Bahir Ismat. I'm ICANN's Vice President for Stakeholder Engagement in the Middle East. Welcome to ICANN 60. We are very pleased to be here in Abu Dhabi and in the Middle East. It's for the first time that ICANN holds its annual meeting in the Gulf region, and this is of course an opportunity for ICANN to engage closely with the internet stakeholders in the United Arab Emirates and also in the region. ICANN, as many of you know, is responsible for coordinating the internet naming and numbering system. It's a technical function that we perform in close cooperation with many other parties, both in the technical and the non-technical communities. I'm based here in the Middle East. I work out of Cairo, Egypt, and my team covers Middle East and North Africa, and we work very closely with the Middle East community on several projects and programs in relation to our mission, programs like capacity development in areas pertaining to domain name system, Arabic domain names, some of the work we do also with business community, with private sector companies who work in the field of internet. We do engage with non-technical and non-commercial groups from civil society, universities, and so forth. So welcome again to ICANN 60. We'll be very happy to take any questions. And with that, I'd like to turn it over to our chairman of the board, Steve Crocker.
Thank you, Bahir. Echoing what Bahir has said, and we are absolutely delighted to be here in Abu Dhabi, to be in the Middle East and the Gulf. It is, I think, our first opportunity to have done this. It's quite exciting. The energy and sort of enormous technological progress that we see all around us in the region is quite heartwarming and motivating. Bahir made mention about our annual meeting. This is indeed our annual general meeting, and at these meetings there is a certain set of changes every year on the board. I'm rotating off the board, but so are some of my colleagues, Naya, Rahim, Asha, Umajani, Marcus Coomer, and Thomas Schneider, and new people coming on board. We have quite a smooth succession process, a very strong induction of new board members which has already taken place. And so you will see at this meeting in the public settings where the full board is participating, both the current board members and the incoming board members sitting together. And we try to treat the incoming board members in all respects as full participants, save for the legal formality that they can't vote today, but in a few days' time they will have vote and a few of us will disappear. Yoran will shortly talk about the more important aspect of the many topics that are currently underway and receiving considerable attention at this meeting. I'll be happy to take any questions after he speaks.
Good morning. We've 350 sessions during a very short period of time. There are many topics to discuss. So instead of talking about all of them, I will pick one of my favorites. And it's also part of the why we are here theme. ICANN as an international and global organization is here as an important part of the internet. But we are not the internet. We are together with our technical partners and other ones provide a service to the world. And to be able to do that, we also have to have an understanding of local versus global. An example of that are the what we call the IDMs, the ability to have local scripts also in Arabic countries. ICANN as an organization together with the community do spend a lot of time for that. And the reason for that is simple and also complicated. I think everybody understands that we today with 3.5, whatever, 4 billion users around the world, we reach very much the easy ones, the ones who live in cities, the ones who can afford access, the ones who maybe need it in the context. But we tend to believe, or we are a strong believer, that the intellect can make a difference for people. That means that we have to develop ourselves in such a way so it becomes natural for people who doesn't have that. Therefore, for instance, scripts in Arabic languages is important to us. Because it provides, in fact, it provides an opportunity for new people to come on board with this global network. It's one of the it's one of those obstacles that we have to learn more about, how do we keep the globally interconnected system, but as well have a great respect for history, culture, which are very local. And that's the underlying reason also why we rotate around the world. Very pleased to have this first meeting ever in the region, because it's a testament to our mission. Thank you.
Thank you. Just before the questions start, if you can introduce yourself and the publication you work for and ask the questions. Again, Arabic interpretation is available, so feel free to speak Arabic if you need to. There's interpretation to English and vice versa.
My name is Mohammed, I'm from Telecom Review. Your conference this week, a lot of topics discussed. As you mentioned, what is the interest to this region? I see a brief of your portfolio wherein one of your roles is to set international domain names, addresses. But from a layman's perspective, how can you just reach out to the users here on your role to the internet here?
It's a very good question. How do we reach people? Well, at this meeting now, I'm not 100% sure, I don't want to give the numbers, but I think we have more than 2,000. So how many from the region?
We have over 250 from across the Middle East and another 200 from the United Arab Emirates.
And it is, if you take away all the sort of how we do things, the diversity of coming into ICANN, we're not a club. Anyone can register or come in here. And if you have a good opinion that's shared by many, you will see that opinion becomes a policy. When that becomes a policy, what happens then is that possibly the way the interface, the domain name system, for all internet users change. So it's one of these things that we always struggle with, but we also try to do as best as we can. We will never be 100% to reach out to more anything from civil servants, so civil society, academia, business interests, governments, to have them all to come into this. This is going to be a lengthy answer because it's a very good question and many demos, so I'm going to add one more thing. The gentleman to my right side is one of the founding fathers of the internet itself. And I usually ask Steve, and he can make a joke by himself, if we work according to plan. And he claims that we do. But the honest is that no one has done what we've done before. No one has created the domain name system, no one has created what we call the internet, and no one has created ever an organization like ICANN. It's built into the system, we always have to challenge ourselves, ask ourselves, are we doing the right thing? I'm very proud of being part of that.
Hello, my name is Pierre. I'm the publisher of the Security Review magazine. I don't know who to ask my question, which is, someone can take us through the mission objective of the key signing, key rollover.
Feels like that's for me. It's challenging to not get into too many details and try to do a tutorial on cryptographic signing of keys, but of the DNS records. DNSSEC is an addition to the basic domain name system structure that adds cryptographic signatures for every single record. This is intended, and its purpose is to increase the integrity of the prevent false information from being sent around or from being accepted by somebody in case false information is sent around. It has nothing to do with privacy, it just has to do with authentication. The scheme involves a hierarchy of keys in which lower level key is signed by higher level key, which is signed by higher level key, which is signed and so forth. And at the very top of this hierarchy is a key associated with the root. And it is necessary for all of the users across the internet to have a copy of the corresponding part of that key in their systems. Every once in a while, it's good practice to make a change to that, and therefore you have to propagate out to everybody what the new key is going to be. That process has been started, and we have taken a pause in it because some measurements have come in that suggest that some fraction, small fraction, nonetheless a noticeable fraction of the end users and systems are not accepting the new key and are not yet ready. So we're extending basically the process in order to provide more time for them to become ready and for us to have a deeper understanding of why they aren't ready and to see if there's something deeper going on.
Is it going to help in any future measurement?
I'm sorry, say it again.
Is it going to help ICANN in measuring any anomalies, any...
There is a measurement process underway, as I said. Some preliminary measurements arrived, and there is now quite active work in developing more precise and more extensive measurements, and it's not just ICANN, but we're working with the entire community on this.
Thank you.
Monika Arndt for Heise Online. I have a follow-up to this one. The percentage of failure that you saw in that measurement was around 4 or 5%. Would you say there is a number that would be low enough that you would go, or would you have to accept at some point in time that you have to roll and combine future steps for your procedure?
Yeah, I understand the question, it's a perfectly reasonable question, but I don't want to answer it here in this forum. A discussion like that would suggest that there's a decision that's been made. There is, so far as I know, a discussion and consideration of that, but it will be for people who are more actively involved in this, particularly our Chief Technology Officer, but others as well, to comment on that. I think that as we get more measurements and as they have more time to focus on that, and they can speak to that more precisely. I'd like to leave things at a qualitative thing at point at this state at this point.
I have these two questions, one for Mr. Crocker and one for Mr. Abdelrahman. For Mr. Crocker, I want to ask some government's needs speaks about some restrictions. They want some restrictions on the internet to face some terrorism acts, some ethics, something like this. Is there any agreement in this meeting about any restrictions on the internet about this? أستاذ عبد الرحمن كنت عايز أسأل حضرتك المدير العام اتكلم في الاجتماع هو في الجلسات الافتتاحية حوالين مسألة ربط الشبكة بين الإمارات الدولة ممكن يعني في تفاصيل أنا ما فهمتش إيه القصد ده. الحاجة الثانية ما هو عدد أسماء النطاقات المسجلة باللغة العربية في الإمارات؟ شكرا.
Let me speak briefly to your first question and also take this moment to recognize the man on my right, Shireen Shalvi, is currently vice chair and will only in a few days succeed me as chair, and particularly relevant at this moment with respect to your question. I get to avoid having to think about your problem, but he doesn't. So going forward, our business at ICANN is very much to stay away from issues of content. We're quite aware that there's various concerns, interests, and attempts to control content on the internet for various purposes. The internet's become entwined with every aspect of our life, and so it touches on very deep issues in politics and human values. And I think it's one of the most important things is that in order for us to do our job of providing a stable system that people can depend upon, is that we try to keep it as separate as we can from the political arguments and the various attempts to take the infrastructure and turn it into a method of control. There's other ways to do that. Lots of issues to discuss that, but we try to stay very far away from that.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. بالنسبة للسؤال حول الرابط الشبكي بين الإمارات، المقصود فيه هو مشاريع الحكومة الذكية. عندنا اليوم شبكة اتحادية تربط جميع الجهات الاتحادية وأيضا تضمن ربط أيضا مع الجهات المحلية في كافة الإمارات. وطبعا نحن نعمل بشكل وثيق مع باقي الجهات لجعل كل الخدمات الذكية مترابطة فيما بينها بحيث يكون في تبادل بيانات مباشر، خدمات بالنسبة للمتعامل تكون يعني one stop shop مثل ما يقولون، ما يحتاج أن الشخص يروح أكثر من جهة، يروح جهة واحدة ويخلص معاملاته في الباكراوند بين تبادل بيانات ما بين الجهات. فهذا هو المقصود في موضوع الربط الشبكي بين الإمارات المختلفة. بالنسبة لعدد النطاقات، اليوم عندنا 210,000 نطاق تحت النطاق الدولي اللي هو .AE. هناك احصائيات اخرى ان في ايضا حوالي 200,000 نطاق من دوله الامارات مسجل تحت نطاقات عالميه اخرى غير الدوله. اليوم احنا نعتبر الاعلى في العالم العربي، 200,000 يعتبر رقم كبير بالنسبه للمنطقه. واعتقد ان بعدنا يمكن
on this question of neutrality and infrastructure and how far I can should be away from the content. So there are discussions here in the meeting, I understand, to push ICANN more into neutrality and being neutral on content. Would you say that ICANN should rethink its policies in that regard? So if you perhaps the first question, do you see registries and registrars as part of the infrastructure? And if yes, should ICANN in its contracts foresee neutrality for them with regard to content? And I would even ask him for Arabic host, perhaps if he can answer this question.
Perhaps I can answer. No.
So I can already, just to elaborate on my question, I can already make some obliges registrars to consider content issues at the moment.
As we said, no.
The answer is no.
The answer is no, you won't change the contracts to have a neutrality obligation, or the answer is no, you think you are already in content with you.
We will not change our contracts for that, and no, we're not in contact.
So I'll answer that in the perspective of .ae. So that's nothing to do with ICANN. Or the generic names that are under the framework of ICANN. So that's only for UAE and applies only for .AE. So we have policies in .AE that would prevent abuse of the name of the domain name system in the UAE for .AE domains. And in case there was an abuse and the domain name is used in a way that is harmful for the users, then potentially those domains will be reviewed and perhaps it will be taken down if that was in the best interest of the user and in compliance with the legal framework, the UAE law. But that's, as I said again, I repeat, that's nothing to do with ICANN policies. It's only for .AE because we are also the operator of .AE CCTLD, and I imagine various CCTLDs have different policies depending on their environment. Some of them may touch into